Welcome to ABC Interactive English. That is Karen.
And that is Henry.
Mm-hmm. And today we are looking at day two of our stories and fables, and it's still called The Bounded Donkey. And the vocabulary words are...
Wise. Wise. Dad was wise not to buy that TV.
Priest. Priest. I didn't know Joe's uncle was a priest.
Gesture. Gesture.Jessica saw her bus, so she gestured for it to stop.
Usual, usual. Peter is going to his usual place for lunch.
Mm-hmm.
Hey, Karen, do you like Tom Cruise?
He's all right, not my favorite actor, but he's okay. Why?
Oh, because I read in an interview that if he didn't become an actor...He was well on his way of becoming a priest.
Really?
Yes,
he was going to become a priest if he weren't... Okay.
Yeah, if he didn't start acting, if he didn't learn about dramatic arts, he was planning on becoming a priest.
I never knew that about Tom Cruise.
Which goes to show you the passion that he has for acting.
Mm.
You know, because becoming a priest takes a lot of devotion and a lot of faith, you know. So if he, it also means that if he didn't choose, if he chose acting instead, he must have had a real passion for dramatic arts as opposed
to dedication.
Right, exactly. So, you know, maybe that is why his career has lasted for over 30 years.
That's true. And he's still making movies until today.
Yeah, he's got maybe two or three every year. Mission Impossible 6 or 7 now.
That's true.
Yeah.
Okay, and the question for today is, what did the priest do when he saw the potter and the donkey?
What did the priest do when he saw the potter and the donkey? And Brad Pitt wanted to be a journalist.
Oh yeah, you told me that. I like Brad Pitt.
The bonded donkey. The potter finally decided to lie down next to the donkey.Then he tried to keep the donkey from running away by holding onto its ears. This was not a good solution. The donkey wasn't comfortable, and the potter couldn't get any rest. A wise old priest walked by and saw this scene. He gestured to the potter and asked what was going on. The potter explained, "Take your donkey to the usual spot and pretend to tie it up there.Said the priest. I promise it won't run off.
Explanation 1.
Hi, I'm Mike.
And I'm Hanny.
Welcome to day 2 of this month's Stories and Fables unit. We are reading the story of The Bonded Donkey.
Right, it's about a potter, a man who makes pots out of clay, and the donkey that he uses to help with his work. When we left our story yesterday,The potter was about to tie up his donkey while they took a rest, when he realized that he didn't have the rope that he usually uses to make sure that the donkey doesn't wander off.
The potter obviously can't afford to lose his donkey, so he's trying to find a solution to this problem. Let's start reading today's article to find out what happens. We read, The potter finally decided to lie down next to the donkey.So he was too tired to do anything but take his rest. I hope the donkey is well behaved and doesn't run away.
Well, the potter sort of had a solution to that. The next sentence tells us, Then he tried to keep the donkey from running away by holding on to its ears. An interesting strategy.
An interesting strategy, but maybe not brilliant. We read in the next sentence, this was not a good solution. So there you go. And we learn why it wasn't a good solution in the next sentence, which says, the donkey wasn't comfortable, and the potter couldn't get any rest. So no one is having a very good time, are they?
Sure doesn't sound like it. And it's at this point in our story that we will take a break. But first, we have one last sentence which brings a new development to our story. We read, A wise old priest walked by and saw this scene. Okay, we'll find out more about this new character after our break.
But before we take the break, let's learn more about two new vocabulary words which we just saw in that last sentence. The first word is wise. Wise. Wise, it's an adjective. If someone is described as wise, that means that they are smart or intelligent, especially with knowledge that they have learned through life. You can become intelligent from reading lots of books or studying hard in school, but you become wise from living a long life, having many different experiences and learning from them. For example, the wise old woman told us to not worry too much about trends and fashions.
那一位有智慧的老妇人叫我们不要太在意这些流行时尚的东西，毕竟那都是一时的风潮。Wise 这个单词它是形容词，表示有智慧的或者是聪明的。例如 ，Being older doesn't necessarily make you wiser. Being older doesn't necessarily make you wiser. 年纪变得比较大，并不代表更有智慧。年龄跟智慧不一定成正比。好，我们例句里面的 necessarily 它就是表示必定的或是必然的。另外 wise 也可以用来形容明智的，像是 It was wise of you to book the tickets in advance. It was wise of you to book the tickets in advance. 你有事先订票就是很明智的。好，接下来我们来学今天的第二个单字。And we had another new word there, didn't we, Mike?
We sure did, Hanny, and that word is priest. Priest, this is a noun. A priest is a holy person who leads or has power in some kind of religious group. Priests will have studied the religion for many years. Maybe they have gone to school to study it, and their work is to help and lead other people who follow that religion. Often priests will also work full-time in a church or a temple. The female version of a priest would be a priestess. For example,The priest raised his hands and began to say a prayer.
那位牧师举起手，接着就开始祷告。Priest, 这个单字它是指牧师或者是神父，它是当名词来用。例如 ，The mother told her children to pay attention to the priest. The mother told her children to pay attention to the priest. 那位母亲教她的孩子要专心聆听牧师讲话。好，再看一个例句。The priest wore a black robe and a white collar. The priest wore a black robe and a white collar. 那位神父他穿着黑色的长袍，还有白色的领子。好，那我们在第一天故事读到，陶工忘了带绳子，没有办法把驴子跟树绑在一起。那他最后就决定躺在驴子的旁边，然后手拉着驴子的那两只耳朵，防止他跑走。这方法呢，听起来有点好笑，而且又不太妥当。一来驴子不舒服，二来陶工也没有办法好好休息。好，我们文中一个补充单字 solution， 它表示解决办法。好，那接着当陶工在苦恼的时候，刚好有一名聪明的老牧师经过，看到这一幕。好，那我要先休息一下，待会再看看老牧师可不可以想到聪明的解决方法。And that brings us to the break.
We'll be back soon to finish off today's part of the story.
Welcome to 就爱讲英文，我是悠悠，
我是吉安。
星星之火可以燎原啊，但是火的这个紧急状况发生的时候，我们该怎么应对呢？
对，虽然说我们台湾的夏天非常的潮湿，但是呢，还是要
随时小心火烛。
小心火烛，对，那么来讲一下跟失火相关的用语。
失火了，失火了，失火了，灰秀出啊！
灰秀出啊，就是 fire。Fire 这个字就是代表火，代表燃烧。
是，
那你可以说 There's a fire.
There's a fire.
就是有东西失火了。
There's a fire.
There's a fire. 现在有火是窜出来了，或者是某个东西烧起来了。Something is on fire.
On fire.
On fire.
比如说房子失火了。
The house is on fire.
The house is on fire.
对。
哇。
烧起来啊！
烧起来，办公室失火了。
The office is on fire.
The office is on fire. 我的心失火了。没有了，没这件事情。当火警发生的时候，要立刻搜寻住家或公共这个公共场所的安全梯。安全梯，怎么说
？Where is the fire escape?
Where is the fire escape?
Escape 它当动词是逃脱嘛，对不对？好，但是当名词的话，就是它逃脱的地方，好，逃脱的这个楼梯啦，安全梯就是 fire escape。
Fire escape、
对，那如果
需要那个
小的时候 对，拿灭火器，对不对？啊，灭火器这个字很长哦，
很重要。
Fire extinguisher。
Fire extinguisher。
对，这个字要再念的时候 ，extinguisher。
extinguisher。
Fire extinguisher。
对，哦、
就是灭火器哈、哦。那这个可以的话就把它扑灭，不行的话就赶快绕跑啦，我就赶快走了。
一定要绕跑啊！
对对对。
如果否那个火警发生在住宅公寓的地方，
火警发生的时候，
不要学我讲话，你要发挥守望相助的精神，
对
不对？我们要协助大家逃生，尤其是火势太大的时候，很可怕、欸。
火势太大，对不对？
对。
那就说这个控制不了了 ，The fire is getting out of hand。
没办法处理了嘛？
对对，已经抓不住了。Getting out of hand 已经抓不掉啊。
好、
它其实就等于 getting out of control 的意思啊。
The fire is getting out of hand。
嗯哼，那你刚刚说就是要叫大家赶快出去，对不对？
赶快跑
！OK， 那就大声呼喊哈。你说，哎，那我们帮大家出去好了哈。Let's help everyone get out。
Let's help everyone get out。
我们来帮大家赶快出去好了。Get out， 它其实有很多用法，很多意思啊。那通常我们要叫人家滚蛋的时候，就是。
Get out of here!
Get out of here! 对，那这边呢？Let's help everyone get out. 我们赶快离开这个地方，逃离的意思。
所以等待消防车抵达的时候，也要尽可能的呢，赶快从这逃生出口脱离火警。
对对对，那这个消防车就是 fire truck.
Fire truck. 嗯，
那逃生出口呢？其实。很简单，
很重要。
就是、在电影院一定要看到这个哈，或者是很多地方。Exit 怎么念 ？Exit。
Exit.
Exit. 所以你就说、啊、你要带领大家逃生，说 Everyone follow me to the exit.
Everyone follow me to the exit. 哦，接下来就这一招把他赶走了啦。接下来看我们的 live action. 啊 ！Everyone get out. There's a fire. There's a fire.
Really?
Where is the fire escape?
It's on the other side of the hallway.
Wow, the fire is getting out of hand. Let's help everyone get out.
Yeah, okay, everyone, follow me to the exit.
Follow me.
Explanation 2.
Hi, and welcome back. Our potter with a problem was trying to take a nap while holding his donkey's ears to keep it from running away.A priest who happened to be walking by at the time saw what was going on. Let's go to our question of the day now to see if the priest can help in any way. The question is, what did the priest do when he saw the potter and the donkey?
He gestured to the potter and asked what was going on. He gestured to the potter and asked what was going on. And Mike will now tell us more about the third new vocab word which we saw in that first sentence.
And the word is gesture. 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 This is a verb. To gesture is to make a movement with your body, especially if that movement is meant to say or communicate something. If someone waves or points or puts up their thumb, all of these gestures are meant to send a message of some kind.Just be sure that you don't make any rude gestures. And yes, gesture can be both a verb and a noun. For example, the waiter led us to our table and then gestured for us to sit down.
服务生把我们带到座位上，接着就用手势动作请我们坐下。Gesture, gesture. 这个单词在课文里面是当动词，就表示用手势或者是用动作来表达，用手势动作来示意。例如He opened the door and gestured for his friend to enter. He opened the door and gestured for his friend to enter. 他把门打开，用手势动作来叫他朋友进门。另外 ，gesture 可以当名词，它除了指这个手势啊、示意动作，也可以用来指表示，像友好的表示、善意的表示这一类的。例如 ，She bought a coffee for the new worker as a friendly gesture.She bought a coffee for the new worker as a friendly gesture. 她买了一杯咖啡给那位新来的员工，当作友好的表示。好，回到故事里面，刚刚说到有一位聪明的老牧师经过，他对着陶工挥挥手，然后就问他发生了什么事。陶工把事情说了一遍。Well, back in the story, the next sentence tells us the potter explained. He explained his problem.
And after the potter explained his problem, we read what the priest thought.Take your donkey to the usual spot and pretend to tie it up there, said the priest. I promise it won't run off. That's strange. I wonder how the priest can promise that.
Yeah, so do I. We'll be finding out tomorrow. But for now, we need to have a look at the word usual because it is our final new word for today.
Usual. Usual. It's an adjective. Something is usual if it is normal, regular, or expected. If you say that you had a usual day, then your day was pretty normal and nothing too strange, different, or exciting happened. If you eat a sandwich for lunch most days, then you might say that is your usual lunch. It is normal and not the opposite, which would be strange or unusual. For example, 11:30 p.m. is the usual time for Belinda to go to bed.
Belinda 通常都在晚上11点半就寝，准备睡觉。那么 usual 这个单词它是形容词，用来形容平常的或者是通常的，像是 Let's meet at the usual place. Let's meet at the usual place. 我们老地方见。好，另外你也可以用 as usual 来表达像往常一样。例如 As usual, he got up at 6 in the morning and went jogging.As usual, he got up at 6 in the morning and went jogging. 就跟往常一样，他早上六点起床，然后接着去慢跑。好，顺便提醒同学们 ，usual 的字尾再加上 ly 就变成副词 usually， 那就表示通常。像是 she usually has bread and coffee for breakfast. She usually has bread and coffee for breakfast. 她早餐通常是吃面包配咖啡。好，回到故事里面，牧师提供一个好方法。他叫陶工把驴子带到他们平常休息的地方，然后假装把它绑在那里。牧师还挂保证说驴子绝对不会跑掉。好，文中一个动词 pretend 它表示假装。好，那今天的课文就读到这里，同学们要记得收看第三天的课程哦，看看牧师的方法有没有奏效，驴子是不是会真的会像他说的一样乖乖待在他们平常休息的地方呢？Well, we're all out of time now.
But we'll be back for the final part of this article tomorrow. See you then.
Bye-bye. Bye-bye. The bonded donkey. The potter finally decided to lie down next to the donkey. Then he tried to keep the donkey from running away by holding onto its ears. This was not a good solution. The donkey wasn't comfortable, and the potter couldn't get any rest.A wise old priest walked by and saw this scene. He gestured to the potter and asked what was going on. The potter explained, Take your donkey to the usual spot and pretend to tie it up there, said the priest. I promise it won't run off.
欢迎收看全民说英语，我是 Daphne。 今天我们总共要解析两则文法，第一则是 A 让 B 不要做某事的句型， A keeps B from 加 VING。 第二则是表示 A 问 B 发生什么事的句型， A asks B what is going on。 让我们从 A 让 B 不要做某事的句型开始吧。A keeps B from 加 VING 意思是 A 让 B 不要做某事。 Keep 在这里是及物动词阻止的意思，后方先接受阻的人事物当受词，再用介系词 from 以免引出阻止的事情，合在一起 A keeps B from VING 字面意思就是 A 阻止 B 以免点点点。例如 The teacher kept the children from yelling. 老师阻止小朋友大吼大叫。接着来看下一则文法。A asks B what is going on, 意思是 A 问 B 发生什么事。Ask 是授予动词询问的意思，后方要接两个受词，一个受词是人，另一个受词是东西。在 A asks B what is going on 这个句型中，我们先接人 B， 再接事物当受词，而这里的事物受词是由 what 什么引出的名词子句。 Go on 是动词片语发生出现的意思，多用于进行式，合在一起 A asks B what is going on 就是 A 问 B 发生什么事。例如 Emma saw her house was a mess, so she asked her cleaning lady what was going on. 艾玛看到家里乱七八糟，所以询问打扫阿姨发生了什么事。以上就是今天的两则文法，全民说英语，我们下次见咯。
A sentence a day.
Hello, welcome to A Sentence a Day with Dr. Henry. 你们看病的时候，医生有时候有需要告诉病人说你的状况是如何，所以你可以帮忙他一起，大家一起合作做治疗。那我们大家常常会有一些小感冒嘛，所以这句话常常在感冒的时候就会听到医生说你的喉咙很肿。Your throat is really swollen. That's right. We hear that very often because, you know, usually when we get a common cold, the first thing that goes wrong is probably your throat, you know. Maybe it's swollen or a running nose, or maybe you're sneezing, achoo! Maybe you're coughing. Those are all the conditions and symptoms that you could show when you have a common cold. And one of those things...is your throat is really swollen, and that means you just have a common cold. Don't worry too much about it. Trust your doctor, and your throat is really swollen. So let me prescribe some medication for you, okay, to take care of that swollen throat. See you next time. Bye-bye.
我是 Hanny， 又到我们一分钟的单元咯。那我们今天在 Stories and Fables 学到了四个单字，现在就用一分钟的时间帮大家复习一下。同学们，您都准备好没？一分钟计时开始。好，第一个单字指有智慧的、聪明的，这通常是看书看不来的那种智慧。好，它叫做 wise， wise 是形容词。He came across a wise old woman on the hilltop， 他在山顶上遇见一位有智慧的老婆婆，然后他就消失不见了。好，再看第二个单字是牧师、神父。我要怎么说呢？叫做 priest， priest。The priest announced them husband and wife。牧师宣布他们正式结为夫妻。再看第三个单字是用手势或是用动作来示意，例如说叫一下服务生啊，或者是坐下那一种手势，叫做这个动作叫 gesture， gesture。The manager gestured for him to take a seat。Take a seat. 经理比了一下手势，叫他坐下。好，再看第四个单词是平常的、寻常的，叫做什么 ？Usual, usual. As usual 就是跟平常一样。It's not usual for her to get up so late. 她平常都会早起，这么晚起床并不寻常。好，太好啦！我们在一分钟之内顺利复习完四个单词，同学们表现很棒哦。那回去也要多多复习，多多造句练习。今天的 ABC Interactive English 到此为止，下次见喽，拜拜。Thank you.